Welcome. I just want to welcome you to St. Andrew Presbyterian Church on this Christmas Eve. And I want to say Merry Christmas to you. It is truly a blessing to have us here together as we worship God and remember the story of Christ's birth. So as we do that, I do want to let you know that the bathrooms are behind you in front of me if you need those. And that I hope that we have a time together where we will hear the story of Christ's birth, sing Christmas carols, and invite Christ into our hearts once again. Let us worship God.
You're going to see me doing an awful lot of this tonight.
Bird. We celebrate the coming of Christ, the light of the world.
Emmanuel, God with us. This is what this is where we must mission. That will be the last time.
Is given to us.
Emmanuel, God with us.
Bringing your kingdom of peace to all people on earth.
Christ, we celebrate you here today.
Thank you, Beach family. Let us bow our heads in prayer. Good and gracious God, on this holy night, you gave us your Son, the Lord of the universe, wrapped in swaddling clothes, the Savior of all, lying in a manger. On this holy night, draw us into the mystery of your love. For you have touched the earth this night with your unconditional love. Touch us. Touch our hearts and minds and souls. Join our voices with the heavenly hosts that we may sing your glory on high. Give us a place among the shepherds that we may find the one for whom we have waited. Jesus Christ, your word made flesh, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, in the splendor of eternal light. God, forever and ever. Amen.
In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was a formless void, and darkness covered the face of the deep. While a wind from God swept over the face of the waters, then God said, "Let there be light." And there was light. And God saw that the light was good, and God separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And there was evening, and there was morning, the first day.
Thank you.
A shoot shall come out from the stump of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of its roots. The Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in the land of deep darkness, on them the light has shined. For a child has been born to us, a son is given. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. Okay, you want to sit right there? You can sit right there if you want, and I'll tell a story to you. Would that work? Okay, and come on up. If you're sitting over here, come up with here. Come on, it's gonna be great. It's gonna be great. You can come up. Come on up. You don't want to miss out. This is the fun part. Right here. Okay. Yeah, come sit right here. Perfect. Oh my gosh, this is great. Yeah, you'll just sort of see when they, yeah, I'll tell you. Okay. So glad you're here. Do you know what today is? Christmas Eve. So it's the day before Christmas. And what happens at Christmas time? Why are we celebrating Christmas? Jesus's birthday. Okay. So we're going to sing tonight. We've started singing, listening to scripture, and we're telling the story of Jesus's birth. Now, you know, some stories, and the reason Jesus came is because of God's love, to show us how much God loves us. And so, but we're going to tell the story tonight, singing and reading words. But how many of you have a picture book at home? And sometimes you like to have pictures, right? When you read a story and you rather see a picture than just all words. Have you done that? Well, we're going to have a little picture book. Okay. Last month, I was in Bethlehem, the place where Jesus was born. So I took some pictures. And so I'm going to show you some of the pictures when I was in Bethlehem where Jesus was born. Okay. So that is the city of Bethlehem at night. You see it up there? You see right there? So that, look over there. There you go. There it is.
That, see on the TV screen? That's Bethlehem at night. Okay. Next slide, Don. This is the cave of Shepherd's Field. We're going to hear about shepherds tonight. And this is the cave that they think the shepherds might have been in way back when the angels came to visit the shepherd to tell him that Jesus was born.
So that's
next one. This is the church right there. And you see the picture? It's the picture of the angel up top. And then the
shepherds are bowing their heads down. And you see all the sheep around. And this is in the church there saying, wow, a wonderful, amazing thing happened right here on this spot. And so
this is another picture in the same church where the shepherds were thought to have been visited by the angel. And you see Mary and baby Jesus and Joseph. And the shepherds have now gathered around them with the sheep to say welcome to this world. Okay? Now,
next one, Don. This is
the actual church where Jesus was born. This is called the Church of the Nativity. And inside it looks like this, Don. See how there's
a whole bunch of things in there? That's from
a whole bunch of churches that have been built over and over again on the same site. It's pretty amazing. And then the next one, and that's a church right next door where people are worshiping. And this is in Bethlehem, and it's called Manger Square. But where was Jesus born? In the movie, right? Right? He was born, and then we placed him in a manger. So that whole place is called Manger Square. And the last one, Don. And that's the place that they think Jesus was born. And so they have worship service there all the time to just say, thank you, God, for giving us your son. So,
not only did I take pictures when I went, I also brought back crosses. And these crosses are made of olive wood. So you get one. And you get one. You want to put that on? There you go. And you get one. And you get one. You can put that right over your head. Right over your head. There you go. You get one. Okay. So let's say a prayer. Okay. Dear God, thank you for giving us your son. Thank you for the love that he shows us each and every day. And thank you for the miracle of his birth that we celebrate this night. May our hearts and minds just be filled with your love. In your son's name we pray. Amen. Okay. Off you go. Oh, perfect. There you go. You got it. Okay, are we all gathered now? Okay, let's look to God in prayer. And as we do that, this is going to be a responsive prayer. So when I say, Holy God, your response is, hear our prayer. Holy God, you got it. Let us pray. Father, in this holy night, your Son, our Savior, was born in human flesh. Renew your church as the body of Christ. Holy God. In this holy night, there was no room for your Son in the inn. Protect with your love those who have no home and all who live in poverty. Holy God, hear our prayer. In this holy night, your Christ came as a light shining in the darkness. Bring comfort to those stranded by the storms away from family. Bring comfort to those who struggle with addiction and mental illness. Bring comfort to those who feel isolated and alone. Wrap your love, dear God, around each person who is missing a loved one, grieving a loss, needing your light. Holy God, hear our prayers. In this holy night, the angels sang, "Peace to God, God's people on earth." Strengthen those who work for peace and justice in the Middle East and in all the world. Holy God, hear our prayer. In this holy night, shepherds in the fields heard good tidings of joy. Give us grace to preach the gospel of Christ's redemption. Holy God, hear our prayer. In this holy night, strangers found the Holy Family and saw the baby lying in a manger. Bless our homes and all whom we love. Holy God, hear our prayer. In this holy night, heaven is come down to earth, and earth is raised to heaven. Hold in your hand Maxine Adams and Irma Andrews, and all those who have passed through death into the hope of your coming kingdom. Holy God, hear our prayers. Father, in this holy night, angels and shepherds worshiped at the manger throne. Receive the worship we offer in fellowship with Mary, Joseph, and the saints. Through him who is your word made flesh, our Savior Jesus Christ. And now let us pray as we live the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Yeah. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her.
Now the birth of Jesus, the Messiah, took place in this way. When his mother Mary had been engaged to Joseph, but before they lived together, she was found to be with child from the Holy Spirit. Her husband Joseph, being a righteous man and unwilling to expose her to public disgrace, planned to dismiss her quietly. But just when he had resolved to do this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what had been spoken by the Lord through the prophet. "Look, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and they shall name him Emmanuel," which means God with us.
In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no place for them in the inn.
Thank you. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told to them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them.
As we have the joy of being together in worship, we also have the joy of giving our gifts to God. Let us collect our gifts as the bell choir shares our offertory.
Thank you. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem asking, "Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews? For we observed his star at its rising and have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means the least among the rulers of Judah, for from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.'" Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word so that I may also go and pay him homage." When they heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him, yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, or of the will of the flesh, or the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth.
And verses.
I'm going to go to the next one.
I was going to say, please take a picture. Somebody.
Oh no, the picture with you and Colin and the kids by the.
Was that good?
Beautiful.
The stand with me, okay?
Okay. Listen to instructions.
They are, huh? You guys want to play a chime?
Here,
take these instead.
Yeah, not the bell. Here,
we'll
try this.
I promise to make it three points, but
yeah,
there was when
hold on to that part.
Just think if you can ring the same as it goes up.
I guess we forgot her stuff.
Are you done playing?
Yeah,
That are done. Thank you so much for coming. Honestly, I just told her that they were the best Christmas present you guys could have given me was to have you here and him here. I mean, all my friends were really good friends.
Merry Christmas, you too.
Yeah.
Great New Year.
I mean, I don't know what time he's going to be up, but I figured 8-ish. Is that, yeah, that's is that too early or too late? Or? Jammies on and coming in our jammies. Okay. And do you want me to bring the eggs and stuff or not?
Well, we have eggs, that's fine. I have more, but you can bring the ham.
Yeah. Okay, there's not a lot of it, and I'll bring what I have. Then.
I was figuring out some of the new eggs and ham.
Scrambled.
Eggs and ham single. And I think that'd be good. Yeah.
Yeah. All right. I'll bring it. Thank you for coming to see Grandma. You're playing with my barrels. You want to read it? Hold on to it. It's heavy.
Yes.
This well goes that way.
Oh, they're I'm in those. These are
They're pretty heavy. They're heavier than you think they are. And these are not the little ones.
So,
there you go.
Very, very difficult to do in the choir.
There you go.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that was really cool to see. I've made it. Yeah.
We didn't mess up. I mean, most Sundays we make a bunch of mistakes.
Yeah.
That's our tree.
I mean,
do you see it? They turned it off. It's going to bed.
I'm going to turn the heater on, right? Every morning for the past month.
Gotta turn the heater on.
And he turns on the kitchen. Well,